Mark. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Yisrael, and you join me once again in the orbit of Bajor, where four Cardassian captains are apparently waiting to see who dies of old age. Cardassians. They might actually be worthwhile as conquered Jekpui, if they could ever grow spines internally as opposed to externally. Right, let's see what we've got. Well, we've got some fresh gach. I suppose that's something. The question is it still alive? Who knows? Who cares? I'm not going to be the one eating it, that's for certain.
Congratulations, General.
Congratulations, they say. Go to Bajor and help the Federation again, they say, as if there was not enough humiliation already heaped upon my head. I swear the Council is trying to provoke me into committing suicide. Well, I suppose there's nothing to do but hail Commander Akebi again.
We have evacuated everyone we could to Bajor, and we're setting up a base there to coordinate our counterattack against the Dominion. I won't lie to you, though. It's not going to be easy. We were caught completely off guard by Karakhan and his fleet, and the Bajorans are none too pleased to have house guests. You proved yourself in the fight against the Dominion on DS9, and right now I can use all the help I can get. Your government has agreed to allow you to assist in our campaign, and we'll have a better chance of defeating the Jem'Hadar with warriors like you on our side. Transport down to our staging area on Bajor. You will find me there. Captain Kurland will join us as soon as he can.
No doubt once he has finished doing horrible things to Tribbles. And what do you mean on our side? Do you think I would join the Jem'Hadar? You. Well, there's nothing for it. Down to Bajor we go. And if I can manage 30 seconds of listening to prattling about prophets and orbs and celestial temples, well, we'll see how rapidly I vomit. Welcome to Hawthorne, General Komuro. Commander Messia KB asked me to inform her of your... Out of my way. I'm sure she's at the Starfleet base. Where else would she be? Any good Klingon general will be on the front lines with his men not cowering in an office somewhere. Ugh. I suppose we'd better find her. I also suppose I'd better check the map. Now, okay. Right, left, left again. Bajorans. They can't even put up decent street signs, can they? And how are you supposed to tell what that means? Come to Kronos, at least we have proper urban planning in the first city. Fruit! You are selling fruit. That isn't food, that's what the food eats. Right. My friend, I feel the pain in your eyes. I will happily help you commit suicide to regain your honor, assuming I have any left by the time I'm done talking to her. Don't make her regret this. I already regret this. Humph. Lieutenant Jarel Kav, palming me off on some junior officer. A general taking orders from a lieutenant.
How can I help you?
By dying. Reminds us what's really important. I am going to...
Do you need something?
It's insidious. System security. It can't handle increased... Well, if you stopped downloading those Tribble videos...
Right. I'm here to help.
Oh, then. Skip on that side of my attempt. Excellent. Well... Okay. Well, let's start with the holodeck. After we've quietly updated their firewall security protocols. Humph. It should be nice and simple, shouldn't it? Huh. Although I'm not sure what we're going to get here beyond the squeals of holographic tribbles. Ah, oh, for heaven's sake. No, stand still, you miserable little thank you. Be grateful I hit you with the blunt end. Right, activate it. Turn on countermeasures, turn on transmitter, and turn on the recording device. 440 terabytes per nanosecond. That is excessive. I do not need the grunts of Starfleet officers being recorded in that much detail, thank you very much. Right, where next? Starfleet Command, I suppose. Mind you, even they're slumming it. No, not the mail. Humph. Well, that's convenient of him. Thank you. You are completely useless, you miserable little... Pat, are you even going to help me get rid of the body? No, too sozzled in blood wine. Ugh. Countermeasures, transmitter, recording, 307 terabytes. I'd love to know what their audio algorithms look like. Then again, maybe I don't. Anything that inefficient. Right. Where next? Chief Medical Officer, Starfleet Operations, Starfleet Command. Should probably just be starting this from top to bottom and hoping for the best. And that's nothing to do with it. The exchange. Commerce. Do you mistake me for some kind of Ferengi? Ugh, I have a spine. I am not exuding slime. And I am more than 4 feet tall. There is a very noticeable difference. Now then, find somewhere to put this bug. Not in there. In here, perhaps. No. Okay. Dooby dooby doo. Where are the rest of these bug sites? Not on my map at all. Terrific! Round and around we go where it stops, only Fekla knows. They're on the minimap for some reason. Okay, so there's one there just by the lieutenant. Please, please let her try to stop me. It would be so nice to have an excuse to kill somebody. Wait for it. How many Beta Z tactical security officers have they got here? Choppy, choppy. Thunk. Yeah, don't mind me, guys. I'm just butchering one of your red shirts. I realise that's a function in existence. They're very obliging, these Starfleet engineers. Not only can they turn rocks into replicators, but they're completely deaf as well. How handy they are. Right, somewhere in medical. Hello, Chief. Would you mind if I just left this remote listening device here? Nope, but guess who does? I don't believe it. How many times have I killed you? Thank you. Right. What's this console for anyway? There we go. Anti-detection, transmitter recording. There we go. Done. Did I miss something? Maybe. They're cloning you, aren't they? Or is this some kind of penance? Did you... I don't know. Did you turn left instead of right on the parade ground? Forget to polish your boots? I dread to think what kind of heinous crime a Starfleet lieutenant has to commit to be sent on suicide missions repeatedly. I do need to activate this. Mind you, I know what kind of missions you have to fail to be made to do that as a Klingon. Anti-detection, transmitter recording. There we go. Usually just serving dead gach at lunch will do the trick. Right, where next? Starfleet Command, and I need to activate the infirmary bug as well, don't I? Doobie-doobie-doo. I suppose I should be grateful at least I got to kill somebody, even if it is the same unfortunate Benzite 6 times over. Or maybe they're twins. I don't know. I don't really care. At least someone on this miserable planet is willing to give me a fight. Right, where next? Starfleet Command. Which isn't anywhere near there. Right. I suppose it's back to Commander Akebe's office, isn't it? Maybe I should holster that, try not to scare the natives. They should be grateful that there is a Klingon here to defend them, that their beloved Starfleet had the sense to call in proper warriors to do this job. Plant remote listening. You see this map? Yes, it's turning red. That's because there are Klingons in town. You again. Well, I've exterminated your siblings. Let's finish you off as well. Didn't even have time to use the phaser rifle. Pity. He might have been a threat. Countermeasures, transmitter, recording. And jobs are good on. How many missions did I just finish off? Okay. Come on! In progress. What do you mean ready to turn? How do I... Where do I turn this in? Oh yes, contact Klingon intelligence. Yes, well, as long as I don't have to take a belt sander to my forehead next time you contact me, I'll be a very happy man. Let's go back to the lieutenant. Train for combat.
I'm here to help.
A holodeck training program. And what do you mean I was in the battle on Deep Space Nine? Humph.
I'm here to help.
Give me a change. Give me a proper challenge and then shut up and get out of my way. You can help me by doing that. Right. A changing. One of those miserable little shapeshifters. Search suspicious crates for life signs. Yes. Well, that's suspicious, all right. here, Starfleet. Even their holograms run away from a proper fight. I'd like to think the real changelings will be more of a challenge. Is to practice melee. There is no satisfaction in holographic opponents. There is no challenge, no thrill, no poisonous goop on the ground. No, you will not get away like that. That you could burn. Plasma grenade. I sincerely hope real change is more fun than this, but then I suppose Starfleet likes their combat tame, safe, boring. Lieutenant, turn off the safety protocols. Let's have a real fight. Better yet, get in here yourself. Oh great, here we go again. Well, at least it's... Why? Going out of carry for a second, why are half my melee combinations not working properly? What's the point? Where did her arm go? Let's just get this over with. Bring forth this shotgun. Where is it going? Come here, you little puddle. There we go. Got it. Right. End simulation. Because let's face it, you'd like to think that would be a real fight. Find me a proper, well, I suppose flesh and blood is the wrong term. Those things don't bleed, they don't eat, they don't drink. It's not even like the Vorta, gluttonous alcoholic sex maniacs either. That turned out to be a forlorn hope. Wonderful, I'm sure you do. Which poor schmuck do you get to run it for you?
I'm here to help.
Right. More combat scoops and starships. Excellent.
I'm here to help.
Please tell me you've got something that might actually be a challenge. Doubt it. This will be calibrated for wussy little Starfleet vessels. Cruisers. Science ships. Bah! If it doesn't load cannon, it doesn't count. I'm sorry. I like the battleship, but why on earth do you think I require allies for this? I am not some incompetent captain who gets lost 70,000 light years from home. And if you wish to dump holographic Shemhadar onto my ship, bring them on, they were only Romulans. They weren't even real ones at that. Remain away. Take note, however, that this is merely to set up for another attack pass. There we go. Right. Find me a proper foe. I don't. What is this insult? You, Lieutenant. You think I need a fleet to take on these miserable little photocopied soldiers? You mistake me for some kind of cruiser captain who mutters about Shakespeare and peace and diplomacy. No wonder you couldn't hold the station. No wonder you ran from the Shemhadar. If you think we need fleets to take on a single dreadnought. We will show you how it is done. We will take your station. No doubt we will have to give it straight back to you, but such is the way of the Empire these days. We are obliged to make nice because the Council orders it. One day the House of Martok will resume the throne. And then we will have proper restitution against the Federation. If that's the best you can come up with this stuff, if that is meant to be a challenge for Federation captains, this war is as good as over. Right, Lieutenant, I suppose you have a few more exercises for me to run. You might try, but if that's your idea of a challenge, Lieutenant, I hope you succeed. With a bit of luck, your crew will die quickly and painlessly and will not suffer over much from your incompetence. Right, now I have to go and help the Bajorans.
I'm here to help.
Ugh. Well, I suppose some of them have spines and are worthy of respect. The ones who spent 20 years fighting Cardassians with rocks and scavenge disruptors. The ones who didn't give in. I wonder if this Colonel Pol is one of them. Maybe he might actually be worthy of some respect. But probably not.
We have a situation here.
Humph. Yes, well, unless you want Federation boots on your necks, I suggest you learn how to fight. Now then. About happy. You want me to go and speak to a protester? Go and have some diplomat deal with that. Humph. Let's go talk to this religious case member priests. Ugh. They have their uses, I suppose. Of course, it wouldn't have hurt him to give out some directions, would it? Right, where's the temple? Over there. Okay, well, I suppose it's nice of them to have some signage, but would it have hurt to use proper language? Do you people have your people advanced beyond pictograms? Apparently not. Now, where's this Ranjan Ravel? Why am I warping all over the place? Has the orbit of this planet destabilized? No, I seek Ranjan Ravel and you will tell me where he is. Ugh. Excellent, this looks promising. Humph. Such Bajoran religious texts. Well, let's see if there's anything good. Hopefully something about exorcisms. He'd been restrained from harm. I'm not sure whether to be impressed or dismayed. Humph. Let me see. Bahala. That name rings a bell and I cannot place it. Humph. Let me see what else. Observations for the Days of Atonement. Yes. I'm honestly surprised they keep that around. At least not without a note to the effect of this person was a moron. How many of these books am I going to have to oh, for the death chance. Have I got to read all of these? Oh, I've read that one. Keys to Enlightenment, Observations of the Day of Atonement. That is done. The Emissary's Early Life. Cooking! They cook their food, I baff. Rather, the spirit of the food will be consumed by the They're wasting the food. Yeah. And break your fast if it starts to... If your health starts to suffer, you are not putting enough... That is when you are putting the effort in. That is when you are making enough of the sacrifice. Ah, risking your life serves no one. None of these people would last a day on the road to Kalia. If I ever get married, I shall invite the whole of Bajor. They'll be dead within a day and we'll be able to launch an invasion. Observation, the seventh prophecy. Try burning Bateret incense throughout the city. I need some Bateret leaf incense. Wonderful. How did he know I... Well, let's... Hopefully, this is already set up. I'm just hoping I don't need this incense handy. Nope, I don't. Excellent. I wonder if we could amp it a bit. Find some tranquilizers. Mind you, I think Bateret's a sedative anyway. Starfleet should leave Bajor alone. Excellent! I admire the attitude. Are you willing to fight for it, I wonder? Probably not. When the Jem'Hadar come calling, he'll doubtless fold like everyone else. Right, where are the rest of these incense burners? There's one. Well, at least these are showing on the tricorder for some reason. That'll make things a bit simpler. Round and round we go. Where my sanity ends, nobody knows. Doobadoobadoo. Find the burners. Dispense the soma. Let the people be calmed. I have to wonder about the Bajoran religion. If their idea of a crisis is not to tell the people to arm up and prepare for war, but rather to burn herbs and breathe deeply and let your worries drift away. You have to wonder about the Bajorans. It's no wonder they folded when the Cardassians showed up. Probably too stoned out of their minds to fight. Well, most of them at least. Some of them did. Right, how many more of these have I got to do? To dish out the local religious drug enforcement. There we go, just one more after this. And have somebody clean up that wax. Ugh. Municipal cleaning's a waste. Such things would not be tolerated on Kronos. There we go, the last drug dispenser. Hopefully this will do the trick. Alright, back to the Colonel. Maybe he has something more interesting. Having to plow through enough Bajoran religious texts to last me a lifetime has left a taste in my mouth. Speaking of which... Yes. At least they were still alive. The crew did something right! Good. Colonel, I have pacified your civilians. They would burn batteries. Presumably they wouldn't burn their renewal scrolls. Maybe they would! Maybe they don't. I don't know. Soil saver in the greenhouse. grubbing around like some farmer, or access to the Orb of Prophecy and Change. Well, why not? Perhaps because they, I don't know, maybe they were too busy contemplating infinity? Maybe spouting out the fact that it's not linear. Who knows? Let's go ask them and see if we can get a straight answer. Dum dum diddly dum. Right. The Orb of Prophecy and Change. Let's see what we get.
You are not grateful. We saved Bajor at the Cisco's insistence. It cost him dearly.
We moved the fleet, but we needed to put it back.
A hand that remains closed
ceases to be a hand.
The fleet needs to exist, as you must return.
Right, so basically, this is a bunch of time-displaced Dominion reinforcements, and because you couldn't be bothered to do your job properly, we wanted the fleet to cease existing, by the way. Ugh. And a hand that remains closed is a fist, which I am very tempted to use on you five. Ugh. When we get back to Deep Space Nine, the first thing I am doing is taking the Yadim into the wormhole, finding those prophets and personally punching all of them out. Ugh. Bajorans. Well, if those are their gods, it's no wonder they're such a spineless, cryptic people. Would it hurt you all to speak plainly? Colonel, turns out your gods didn't do their jobs right.
Peace and quiet. That's what we need.
Well, it's not what you're gonna get, that's for certain. Commander Kebby. Apparently she needs some help working her comm badge. Why am I not surprised? After all, she's needed our help with everything else. It's a wonder she can even work the replicator. Perhaps she needs to be reminded how to breathe unaided. Much as I'd like to show her how to stop. Right, Akemi, what do you need?
I have new orders for you.
Yes, yes, so you said. Quit repeating yourself. I am not some junior ensign with a 30-second memory span. Right, let's see what we can find. Back. There we are. Humph. With a bit of luck, perhaps he should manage... Yes, perhaps he'll even remember to turn the fusion reactor off when he puts you onto those conduits. It would be a shame if somebody vented plasma. Note to self, get this chief engineer reassigned to my crew. He has the right idea about maintaining discipline and performance amongst junior members. Alright, let's keep scanning, see what we get. Nothing on the terahertz band, switch down to the gigahertz. Accessing niners, I have no idea what this is, but let's find out. Sweets and... No, I would not like to order a Jumja stick. You can stick your zhumzha up your... Bah! Keep looking. There better be something useful on this. A sheer 6-2. Vix versus... No, I don't want to leave a message, except possibly to rise up and overthrow your dominion oppressors. Your holograms, after all, no one cares if you get rebooted. Ah, Hadron! Humph. Of course you don't want us listening in. Did it occur to you that we probably already knew about it? It took me less than 5 minutes to find your signal. Humph. Right, we knew about Karakon, we knew about the Vorta. Actually, yes, that's pretty much what happened, although, strictly speaking, a wormhole's not a black hole. There's a difference between a Vertron tunnel through space-time and a simple quantum singularity. But then you're a Ferengi, how would we be expected to know about such things? Right.
I have new orders for you.
You know what? Actually, I hope they don't leave the station peacefully. That Zhemhadar Karakon looks like a serious piece of work. It would be interesting to match Batleths with him. Or rather, Batleth against Katarkin Polarm. Hasn't got the honour to use a proper sword. However, we need the Militia HQ straight up. Right. I'm borrowing your communicator. I don't really care whether you mind or not. Hail DS9, but let Curlan doing the talking. Humph. Well, if you want to make a foul mess of it, dig your own grave. It's not like I care. And why bother encrypting it? We want the whole sector to hear this.
Who is this? What do you want?
Let's not be so hasty, Karukan. They obviously went to a great deal of trouble to contact us.
No, we just dialed your number.
Dominion, temporary governor of Deep Space 9. How can I help you?
Die. Quickly.
Thank you for agreeing to talk, Loris. I am Captain James Curland of the Federation Space Station Deep Space 9. It is my hope that we can find a peaceful resolution to this conflict.
We won't.
Of
all
course,
know we
Captain.
Won't.
You want your station back. But this is a war, and your station is my prize.
I know this will be hard for you to accept, but there is no war. It's been over for decades. Your fleet was diverted when you attempted to pass through the wormhole. The Prophets... There is a great deal we have to explain, but please, understand, we are not your enemies.
I am not a fool, Captain. We have reviewed the records in DS9's databanks. Why should I believe this fantasy of prophets and time travel? Show me proof that what you say is true.
Look out a window, you stupid woman! Ugh.
The Dominion War continued after a combined Starfleet and Klingon force retook DS9. When the Romulans entered the war on our side, things began to turn. The Dominion recruited the Breen to their cause, but the disease that was attacking the Founders put them on the defensive. They ultimately retreated out of most of the Alpha Quadrant, creating a defense perimeter in Cardassian space. Soon after, a Cardassian official named Damar led a rebellion on Cardassia Prime, breaking the standoff. The Dominion was forced to surrender.
Do not try to deceive me. That cannot be what happened. Why should I believe these recordings are real?
I think we should assuage her feelings of doubt by going over to the station and inserting a batleth up several orifices, but that isn't an option. Humph. Now, while the casualty figures won't work, because those could be faked, they could corroborate with that, I suppose we should just prove the authenticity.
You make a persuasive argument. But I'm not completely convinced. Historical records can be interpreted in many ways. You may be using evidence that supports your premise, and ignoring anything that does not.
You have 30 years of stellar drift. The entire galaxy cannot be faked. Stupid
woman. I will consider your arguments carefully, but you must understand that I am under orders as well. The Founders gave me specific instructions before I left the Gamma Quadrant. I accept that may have been many years ago. Nevertheless, mere time cannot countermand the commands of the gods. We are attempting to contact the Dominion in the Gamma Quadrant. As of yet, we have been unsuccessful. Until I speak to a Founder and receive new orders, we will remain here. Deep Space Nine belongs to the Dominion.
Excellent. So all we have to do is get hold of a Founder, or go to the Gamma Quadrant to figure out why your radio isn't working. Perhaps you should get the Ferengi to tune it. Ugh. Where are we going to get a Founder around here? It's not like Klingon Intelligence have one stashed away somewhere. Mind you, maybe they do. It's not that they'd tell me if they had. Then again, well, it's not that you can impale a Founder and leave a bucket of goo on display in Kronos, so... Humph. They probably don't. Besides, there was one on Cardassia at the end of the war, but... Well, at least the commanders finally made the right decision. Retake Deep Space Nine. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Yuzrel. That has been the latest episode of Clingin On, and hopefully next week we'll actually get back to the killing. Because Lord knows this episode wasn't anywhere near its bloodshed quota. I'll see you next time.